I am Nina Malterud, and I am a ceramic artist. We are here in my studio. I've been working with ceramics now for 50 years. I started the education in Oslo in 1971. The first 20 years, you could say, I was very, very keen on ornament patterns. I was making patterns, drawing patterns, making with clay and with glazes. And now in these later works, it's more like I let the glazes form the patterns themselves within some given frames. So I don't draw the pattern, I leave it, which I think gives another flow in a way. It's a different thing. I wouldn't say better or worse, but it's different. But it's some of the same colors. It's probably some of the same areas of colors and images in a way. I'm very resistant to be defined either as craft or fine art. Or something between two, but because categories are very, I think art should go beyond categories. With these things, the later years, I've tried to make them abstract. I try to remove if there is, for instance, a pattern that everybody will call a tree or whatever. I mean, I don't want them to be a specific representation of something. I want them to be open in that way. I'm working with series mostly. I make 3, 4, 5 in a row. I treat them differently. I see what the differences are. I could see it goes far this way or far that way. And both could be interesting. So I do. I never, very seldom make one piece. I make maybe some of these things I've made 50 different during some years, and I go back to it and do it again and see what has happened since I did it last. Well, on these things, I let the glaze play on the whole surface. I don't interfere with some restrictions of edges or something. It's all over, and they come out very different. For instance, this and this. It is just glazes and glazes and glazes, but they act so surprising that sometimes when I glaze, I can see, oh, here comes an interesting pattern, like this drawing here, for instance. I can see that this might be something. And some of them I can just throw away. When I started, well, years ago, I was very much into a sort of craft ideology, craft defense also, craft as a field of art that was very important. And I was very fascinated also by older artifacts, archaeology items, really old things. And many of these old things are partly functional, but they are also partly spiritual or humorous. Or they're many of these old handmade ceramics, for instance, they're not merely functional or merely this or that. They are combine a lot of things, and that fascinated me. That still fascinates me. So I think a lot of my what I'm working with now is inspired from functional objects like a dish, a bowl, plate, or a tile. But they're also not very practical, to be honest. They could maybe a thing starts as a dish on a table thing, but then it develops to more and more complex imagery, if you could say that. So it's not actually so practical. I think it's interesting with what makes the identity of it. To me, it's obvious that this has to be exhibited on a table, for instance, and this has to be on the wall, and then some are ambivalent and can change. These are definitely for walls. I call these series, which I made a lot of, for weather maps. That just came into my mind. And I don't use titles as a system or as a principle. I just use a title. This doesn't have a title. It's called Long Oval. Sometimes I have started with a form that I'm not quite sure about. And then I adjust the, for instance, the thickness, the size, the colors, whatever. And then I know when I have a format that I want to work with for a while. It's sort of settled. And then I can develop in further in other ways with the glazes and with the next. It's not just the form, it's about the expression of the colors and the surface. I can work a lot with that and test out different things. And then it's important to have many pieces because one cracks, the other is gone. I still have five to go. Like this, I could not foresee this pattern that it has made here, this very organic, regular pattern of the glaze. I did not know. We have so far figured out that maybe one third of the exhibition will be older things, two thirds will be from 2000 and onwards, the last 20 years. These are things back to 1975. I was then working as assistant for another ceramicist, and I made these things on my own. I think I would say these are my first independent works, and they are going to be in the exhibition, and I still like them, which there are many things from that period which I would not present now, I can tell you. I knew we had to work very specifically with the exhibition architecture. Some of these works are quite small. They might be diameter of 15 centimeters. So some of the architecture challenge will be not to to make it intimate, even in the small, in the large room. Because of all this, all these years, I think it's extremely rewarding to be able to exhibit in that format in KODE, which is maybe one of Norway's best museums. I think that contract has made maybe a new space for me these last years, that also to look back, what was this, what was that? Not everything in the back was so fantastic. So it has also been a sort of process of having to look back and evaluating some of the previous work, some of the former settings that I've been involved in. And to me that it's a very good time to do that now. So it's much more than just exhibiting some more works.